Hi everybody and welcome to Align 30. My name is Erin and Sarah is your demo today. Today for class you need a loop band, a block, and a stable surface. Of course weights are always optional. Okay, we're going to start today with your loop band on right where Sarah has it, halfway between her hips and her knees. Grab your block, wrap your feet around the block. Soften your knees a bit, just kind of get settled in a standing position. Roll your shoulders back, roll your shoulders forward, just kind of wiggle it out there. And then take a deep breath in, reach your arms up. And then exhale, lower your arms down. Again, take a big inhale, reach your arms up. Dipping your hands in the water. Is it cold, Sarah? Pretty cold here. I realized when I was reporting the other day about it being cold here that it's like really cold in other places. Like 44 probably isn't cold for most places. All right, reach your arms up, take a hold of your left wrist, take a side stretch to the right. I like to straighten my left leg a little bit, like push my left hip out to deepen that stretch and then go the other way. Good to see you all, welcome. All right, and then a parallel squat. So reach your arms forward, sit your hips back. Let's incorporate the squat and a hinge right away. And then stand back up. Add a little heel raise, challenge your balance. And if you ever feel like you want to hold onto a stable surface during your squat, I've been doing that a lot lately and I really like it. It's helping with my alignment and really shifting the hips back versus letting my knees drift forward. I feel like it's helping me strengthen the posterior chain, which is our theme today. We're focusing a lot on glutes and hamstrings and spinal extensor muscles. My personal belief is that we tend to forget about the things that we can't see. So since all that posterior chain is in the back of our body, sometimes we forget to work it, but not here at Alkalign. Okay, so you have 33 joints in each foot. As you lift your heels, you're mobilizing those joints and strengthening your feet. You have three more. You're going to hold a squat. We're going to add in a pendulum starting on the right, just the right. All right, last one, hold your squat. Okay, this is where Sarah could really benefit from the Hamilton style stage that twirls around, and I could just decide which way she's going to face. Okay, squat down, lift your right leg. Squat. This is called pendulum. So now you're moving from a symmetrical position, both feet on the floor, to an asymmetrical position. Okay, put your hands on your glutes, just like Sarah has, and feel your glutes fire. I'm a big believer when you touch a muscle, ideally the one you want to be working, you can get it to fire a little bit more. And there's this thing called glute amnesia. Have you ever heard of it? Maybe you heard of it, but you forgot. Anyway, our glutes, because we sit on them a lot, many hours a day, they forget to fire, or they don't know how to fire properly. Okay, so put your hands there and get your glutes to fire and be intentional as you lift your right leg up, engage your left glutes in opposition. You have four more counts. We're gonna switch sides in 3, 2, on one. Go right to the other side, this little brain scramble. Yeah, lift your left leg. Now, the reason I have the band on today is sort of like a safety net or a guardrail or sort of like those bumpers in a bowling alley, right? It's to keep your hips relatively level. If you have a light resistance band, you can definitely overlift your leg. Yeah, lift your leg a little bit less, Pauline. Push out like you have a really heavy box next to you, and the most effective way to get that box away from you is to push from the bottom, right? So engage your glutes. Sarah's checking all the things. She's checking the distance between her hips and her ribs. She's checking her abdominal engagement. She's checking her glutes. Now, she's checking so many things that she practically tipped over, but she didn't. Nope, that's just your core stabilizers firing. Okay, you have a few more on this side, and then we're gonna come straight down into a forearm plank. Keep the band on. Okay, that's coming up in 4 counts. 3, 2, and 1. Go ahead and come down to the ground. If you like the block between your palms, you can use that, but not required. Okay, so we're gonna do a plank jack here. You're gonna step or slide your right leg out. Your opposite leg can be lifted or on the ground, and then step it back in. So we're gonna do a couple of plank jacks. If you have any knee sensitivity, I do not recommend plank jacks unless you have really, really strong glutes that can support this lateral movement, especially with the band on. So if you are ever doing plank jacks and you're like, yeah, it just doesn't feel great for my knee, then guess what? Don't do it. Seems obvious, but I think especially in the fitness industry, we tend to do whatever the, you know, professional tells us to do, and we forget to listen to our body. Okay, we're gonna do a little combo here. So you're gonna step your right foot, yeah, go back to the right. Step your right foot out, and now quarter turn into a side plank. But notice how your feet are wide, so it's gonna give her a wider base of support. And then come back through center, step your right leg in, step your left leg out, quarter turn. Move really, really slowly. We are going to be here for about 30 seconds, and I don't want you to feel like you have to rush through or do any amount of, you know, repetitions. I want you to move slowly, and notice when you step your foot wider before you quarter turn into that plank, that challenges your balance in a little bit different way. It widens the base of support, but it's also just different, and that's good for both your brain and your body. Okay, so we started on the right. I want you to do one more and finish on the left, just so you're even-ish. And then once you finish that, come back to your forearm plank and hold that plank in whatever position gives you the most engagement. So take an inhale. As you exhale, traction your elbows towards your knees or towards your toes. The most engagement in your abdominals, not the most engagement in your quadriceps. When I straighten my legs here, I feel it all in my legs. I have really quad dominant, really strong quads. I can hold things with my legs. So maybe set your knees down or take a bend to your knees. You have four more counts. We're gonna thread the needle in 3, 2, on one. Wherever you are, set your knees out, shift your hips back so you're in an all fours position, slide your right arm underneath your left. Hello, Sarah. And then switch sides, slide your left arm underneath your right. And then come into a child's pose. You can open your knees wide, press into the band. I like to wiggle a little bit side to side. If that feels good for you, I suggest that just to kind of release some tension. This is actually a very down-regulating position. Okay, and then turn over onto your back and bring your heels together and your toes apart like you're gonna come into Power V, but your feet are on the floor. Okay, so open your knees out into the band. Sarah, I thought you were gonna put that under your head. Some people really benefit from the block under their head, especially if you're really the alignment challenges with your head and your back. Okay, so bring your heels together. I don't think you need it, Sarah. Okay, heels together, toes apart, tilt your hips under, press your back into the ground, squeeze your heels together and start to push out into the band. So tiny presses out. Now take your hands to the sides of your glutes and feel that fire. Then you can play around and take your hands to your abdominals as you press out into the band. Hopefully you'll feel your abdominals, particularly the transverse abdominis, pull in a little bit more. Yeah, do you feel that? Okay, if you have a slidey glidey surface under you, which I don't think anybody does today, I would recommend using it. We're gonna keep the feet down to start because I actually get more engagement here. There's this little belief that when the legs are lifted, it's harder or better. We are rewiring the brain to embrace new things that are maybe better things. You have 4 counts, 3, 2. All right, last one, hold it here. Keep your back down, keep your abdominals pulled in, and then slide your right heel away from you on the ground, and then pull it back in, and then switch to the left, okay? You can easily slide your leg out and in all day long and feel like, I feel nothing, right? I want you to be intentional about it. Push your heel down and pull your heel in. This is a little push, pull. The band is there to provide a little bit of feedback and a little bit of stability, a little consistency But the floor is also there to give you feedback, as are your hands. So use them. Okay, so this is foot down. I don't move very far, but I feel it a lot more in my abdominals than when I bring my legs up again. Because I'm quad dominant, I feel a lot in my quads and my hip flexors more than I do my abdominals. So this allows me to access and strengthen those muscles a little bit more efficiently. But I'll give you the option to do both. Okay, last one, hold it in, and now one leg at a time, bring your legs up into the same position, but in the air. So you've taken that out of a closed chain of energy, now you're open chain, heels together, toes apart. If you wanna grab your weights and add some skull crushers, that is totally fine. But take an inhale, exhale, pull your abdominals down, pressure back, little tilt of the hips, and then you're gonna take your right leg out with your left leg skull crusher if you want, and then switch. If it's too much to do too many things at once, then skip the weights. We're gonna get a lot of triceps work later. Yeah, Sarah, bring your elbows a little bit more forward so that when you bend your arms, your elbow stays right over your shoulder. Yeah, like more like a 90 degree angle. Okay, when your legs come up, pay attention to where you feel this. Can you still access that deep layer of your abdominals, or you feel like this is more your quads and your hip flexors doing the work? If it's the latter, put your feet back down on the floor. Right, for so long I was convinced that legs up was like harder or better. Turns out that wasn't true for my body. It might be for yours. I see some of you taking one leg down and moving one leg. Move whatever you're moving, whether it's on the floor or in the air, one leg, two legs, whatever it is, move with intention. Okay, last one. If you have gone one leg at a time, then we'll give you a few more so you can switch. All right, and then bring both legs up, straighten both legs. You can separate them. They were in a diamond, now you can bring them into parallel. Good, reach your arms up. Now we're gonna do a double arm skull crusher as your legs go out away from you, bend your elbows. And then as they come in, add a little lift of the hips. Yeah, option to add a little lift of the upper body. So it doesn't have to be huge and it's not very long, but it's just a little bit of hang time where you're challenging your rectus abdominis to lift the load of your upper body away from gravity. And as you get that little tilt, you're lifting your lower body. So everything's kind of meeting in the middle. This is where I pretend like I know something about diving and I call this like a pike position. They probably have that in gymnastics. Yeah. I should learn something about diving because Ava's starting to dive. But she comes home and describes all the stuff she does. I'm like, I don't know. They're like, I went off the 5 meter platform. I'm like, I really need to know the metric system. I think that's pretty high. Okay, you have 6 more counts. You're gonna hold the lift in 4, 3, 2. All right, last one. Hold that lift, pull your abdominals in. You're gonna take the band off in 4 counts. 3, 2, and 1. Set your head down. Please remove the band. Hug your knees in towards your chest and then take your knees up and over to the right for a spinal rotation stretch. Let the weight of your lower body stretch through your thoracic spine, stretch across your chest. You can see Sarah's giving herself a little tactile feedback where she's pulling the ribs one way, her knees the other, and then go the other way. All right, turn on over. We're gonna do a cat-cow and then downward dog. So just a little mobility for your spine. Place your hands down, hands under your shoulders, knees under your hips. Take an inhale, look up, and then exhale, flex your spine. Be mindful about the articulation of your spine. Notice every vertebra. You don't have to go huge range of motion. Sometimes when you start a little bit smaller, it can be more intentional. But this mobility for your spine is really important, especially if you sit all day, things stiffen up. If you could get a little cat-cow between meetings, that would be awesome. Okay, come back to neutral, tuck your toes, lift your hips up, pike your hips up, pedal your feet out. And then walk your hands in toward, and your feet towards each other. Come on up, locate one weight if you want to use it. It's gonna make this a little bit more, a little more compound movement today. But you're gonna step up to your stable surface, so wall, door jamb, desk, whatever you got. Okay. From here, stand on your, let's see, your left foot. So you're standing, you can just go, yeah, you're good. Stand on your left foot. You're gonna take the weight into your left hand. Put your right hand on your stable surface. This is a challenge, right versus left, okay? All right, from here, take your weight into a half circle in front of your chest, like you're giving someone half a hug. Hinge forward, just start with your feet down. Hinge forward and open up, yeah, your arm, and then come back up. So we're starting in a deadlift here. Yep. Both feet are down, so you're pretty stable. For now, that's gonna change in a second. So your hip hinging, imagine you've got a string attached to your sternum and that string is attached to the wall and it's like pulling you towards the wall. You're not dive bombing towards the floor. You're kind of going out and forward. All right, now add the right leg back. Asymmetrical deadlift. Woo! Yep, move slowly with intention. We touched the glutes at the beginning of class, and now I wanna feel that visible hand on your left glutes, hugging in and lifting you up out of your standing leg. Yep. And then another invisible hand on your right glutes, feeling your glutes fire right where your hamstrings attach. Yep. I highly recommend having your hand on a stable surface. Katie, lift your chest up a little bit. Yeah, so turn your gaze, like, instead of down, turn it forward a little bit. Yes! Just got so much longer through your spine. That's good, Ariella. Hi, Jen! Way back there! How's it going? Isn't it amazing how creative we get with our home studio spaces? I love it. Two more. Okay, last one. Hold this forward fold. Soften your left knee if it wasn't already. Sweep your left arm back, turn your left palm in. You're gonna take a little bend and stretch of your left elbow and your right knee. Bend and stretch. So this is tricky because you are weight bearing on one leg and that little glute med muscle on the left side, which is small, has to support you. The other thing that will support you is really good alignment. So if you gaze down for a moment, notice your hip and your ankle are aligned. Bend and stretch. Bend and stretch. Bend and stretch. Really focus on engaging your triceps as you lengthen the arm and engaging your glutes as you lengthen your leg. We're not doing anything too fancy. This is just more of like a balance challenge, and you can get just as much, if not more, engagement without the weights here. You have four counts, three, two. All right, last one. Hold the reach of your arm. Hold that engagement in your leg. Pull your abdominals in. In a moment, you're gonna set your weight back down. Please don't drop it on your toe. And then curl your heel in and open your leg in four counts. Three, two, and one. Set the weight down, okay? And then bend your right knee and open your right hip. Okay, if you're facing away from us, Sarah, it's really hard for you to do that without your table in front of you. Okay, lift your right leg up. So now you've externally rotated the femur bone in the socket. You're lifting your leg up away from gravity. You're also lifting with the support of your abdominals. So if your abdominals space out, your back will start to arch and you'll start lifting with your back. So pull your ribs in, pull your abdominals in. Okay, we're gonna move the leg that's bent. Bigger range of motion, which is gonna feel weird because a lot of times you do this with a long lever. Today we're gonna do it with a short lever. You have four counts, three, two, on one. Two counts, lower your leg down, and two counts, lift up. We're not gonna do it very long. After this, you're gonna come into a parallel quad set facing your stable surface. Yeah, looks good. Everybody has a softened standing knee, which I love. That's great. There is a temptation to lock out your standing leg. We do that a lot when we're standing. Yeah, and then you sit into your low back. No bueno. Two more. Okay, last one. hold this lift up, wrap your leg back, pull your abdominals in, get ready to stand up. If you've got a block handy, awesome, use it. You have four counts, 3, 2, on one, stand up, grab your block, lift your heels, bend your knees and lower down an inch, up an inch. So you went from a fold over, you've done hinging and fold over, now you're upright parallel. Yeah, so untilt your hips. You wanna be in a neutral pelvis here. So make sure your knees aren't kind of drifting forward. You wanna straight up and down versus like going like down a slide. You know that feeling of like you're sort of drifting forward? That happens when your pelvis is sort of tilted under. So go straight up and down. Better for your back, better for your knees. Down and up. Use your hands as tactile feedback. You've got at least one hand on a stable surface, the other hand can be checking all the systems. I know it takes a little while to get used to that self-administered tactile feedback, but it's so important. It's like one leg of a three-legged stool, right? You have the, imagine trying to do all this just watching Sarah without me cueing you. That'd be hard. Imagine just listening to me without watching Sarah. That would be hard, right? The tactile feedback adds that next level of awareness and engagement in your body and that connection between your brain and your body. Okay, we're gonna slow this down. Two more. Okay, last one, lower, down and down. Lift up and up. Yeah, Katie, shift your head back a little bit. Yeah, unless you're looking at something really exciting on the floor. I feel honestly when I'm working out at home, like don't look down. That's where I'm like, oh, there's a Lego on the floor. One time I was taking Sarah's class in my living room and there was literally a Barbie spatula, like Barbie grilling tools, like embedded into the carpet. I'm like, don't look down. You know that movie, Don't Look Up? Have you guys seen that? My philosophy when outlining is don't look down. I don't want to be distracted by what's on the floor. Two more. Last one, hold here. Wrap your heels into the block. Shift your head back, pull your abdominals in, deeply bend your knees. We're gonna switch to the other side. We'll start with the deadlift, but take the weight into your right hand in 4, 3, 2, and 1. Stand up, little hinge forward from your hips. Open the right arm and then stand back up. Okay, so just get set here with both feet down. And by the way, you are welcome to stay both feet down. There's no need to add any additional complexity. If you feel your deadlifts more with both feet down, do that. But traction, as you hinge forward, traction your heels back. And then when you stand up, think about also pulling your heels back. I mentioned at the beginning that we're working a lot on the posterior chain. So I want you to feel this, strengthen all those muscles in your back body. Okay, now take your left hand to your stable surface, slide your left leg back, and you're gonna move from symmetrical to asymmetrical. We're moving really slowly and intentionally for a couple reasons. One, because you just get more out of it. When you speed things up, you lose some of the quality and the intention. Looks so good, Jeannie. But also focus on keeping your hips down. I will also say, usually I see the left hip in this case open and the leg kind of swing back, and I'm not seeing any of that today. So give yourself props for keeping your hips and shoulders square as you hinge for traction your right heel back, and then, yeah, start to the feet. If you're balance challenged, you'll notice it here, one side versus the other. It's not just your feet or your glutes, it could be the way your obliques are firing. Okay, two more. Okay, on this last one, hold the forward fold. Make sure your standing leg is soft. Reach your right arm back, turn your palm in. Take a little bend of your right elbow and your left knee. Bend and stretch. The focus here is on engaging the triceps as much as you can, engaging your left glutes as much as you can. I know it's hard to think about more than one thing at a time, but in life, we're doing a million things at a time. Right, so if we can train our brain to be a little bit more aware, bend and stretch, bend and stretch, bend and stretch. Yeah, the emphasis is on the lengthen, and I don't care if you're using no weight or 200 pound weight, it's the same. It starts in your brain, right? Engage the muscles. Okay, you're gonna set your weight down in 4 counts and open your left hip in 3, 2, on one, gently set the weight down, bend your left leg, open your left hips, wrap that leg back. Yep, dip your toes in the water, Sarah, and lift your leg up. This is a hard one to do at home because our stable surfaces have so much variation. But it's good to practice standing postures. We spend a lot of time on the ground in class, which I love. And the ground is consistent and everybody has one. But at some point we have to stand up. Are you turning your standing toes in, Sarah, for a reason? Oh, does it feel better on your hip? No? Or did you realize you're doing that? Were you doing that intentionally? Oh, no, isn't it crazy? That's the beauty of these live stream classes. Like, we can give you feedback. Like, Katie, wrap your knee back a little bit more. Or CZ, check out what's on the 6th shelf instead of the bottom shelf, right? Better align your neck. Is that fun? Okay, you're gonna go bigger range of motion in 4 counts, 3, 2, on one, lower your leg down, lift it up. You guys are almost finished. This is really intense, I know. We're gonna do a little power V after this. No weights. Even if you desperately wanna use weights, no weights, no weights. I'm gonna make you engage your biceps and quiver with no weights. We rely so much on those external forces to do the work for us. Ain't that the truth? I will hold my opinions about many other products on the market to myself. Okay, 2 more. We don't have time for that today. All right, last one. Hold this lift up. Wrap your leg back. Pull your ribs back. Yeah, hold here 4 counts. You're gonna stand up. Power V in 3, 2, and 1. Nice job. Go ahead and stand up. Bring your heels together. Toes apart. Turn your palms forward. Lift your heels. Bend your knees. And you can either hold on or do a biceps curl here. Curl your arms as you lower and then lengthen as you lift. But really, really squeeze your biceps. Remember, you're working in both directions. Concentric contraction as you bend your elbow, eccentric contraction as you lower the arms, and you actually get more out of the lowering. So if you're ever tempted to like pick something up and then drop it, a weight, a box, just think, ooh, I'm missing out on the strengthening opportunity. It's also a little bit dangerous and potentially harmful to the box of puppies that you're dropping. So be kind to the puppies. That's always what I imagine putting down. Good, 2 more, curl as you lower, press as you lift. Last one, hold the curl, turn your palms in, lift your elbows up to shoulder height. A little press up with your elbows, anterior deltoid press, press up. I thought you were gonna go for a nose scratch there, Sarah, but you're just peering. Maybe saying hi to someone, your tech crew behind the camera. No, just kidding. There's no tech crew at Alkalign. There's also no script, as you can tell. We're really good at going off script. Okay, you have 6 more counts. 5, 4, 3, 2. Last one, I'll hold it here. Hold 4 more counts. We're gonna do standing quad stretch in 3, 2, and 1. Nice job. Go ahead and stand up. Take your right ankle into your right hand. Soften your left knee. Oh, I know what that is. That's my heater just kicked on, you know, because of those frigid 40 degree temperatures here. There's a reason I don't live in upstate New York anymore, friends. Okay, switch sides. I'm a total wimp when it comes to the cold. All right. And then go ahead and come down to the ground. We're gonna do something kind of like a scissor walk. Bring your legs up, but it's gonna be a scissor walk slash dynamic stretch. Okay, so Sarah's gonna demonstrate. Okay, instead of lowering your long lever leg away from you like that, you're gonna bend that leg and you're gonna reach up to your opposite ankle. Yep, There you go. And then switch sides. But I want you to move really slowly. One, for the benefit of your abdominals, and two, so you can flex your foot and press your heel up away from you, little hamstring stretch. Okay, so you're getting little abdominal work, and you can choose to hold on to your ankle, or you can just reach up towards your ankle and not touch it. I just kind of move kind of like a scissor walk, but I just bend the leg and press the heel up, and then I feel a little bit more stretch, a little bit more intention. We've done a lot of work for the hamstrings, so I want to make sure that you're getting a little stretch here. Yeah, and because you're curling your upper body away from the floor and rotating, you're getting a little bonus abdominal work, which should feel somewhat familiar to the very beginning of class. Okay, you have another 10 counts here. And then you're gonna lower down into a figure four. You've got 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice job. Go ahead and lower down, cross your right ankle over your left leg. Thread your hands through. Give yourself a little gentle stretch. We did a lot of glute work. We're doing little hamstrings. We did a little hamstring stretch, a little glute stretch. You can flex and point your feet. Roll your ankles around to mobilize the ankles. Okay, and then switch sides. Cross your left ankle over your right. Okay, and then come into a figure four stretch. Take your feet out wide. Hold on to the outsides of your feet. Pull down with your hands, press up with your feet. Traction your toes back towards your nose. This is where all the furry friends wake up and you're a little bit sweaty and they want to lick your face. A little salt lick. Good times. All right, and then bring your feet down to the floor. You can either bend your knees if you have any back sensitivity or lengthen your legs all the way. Turn your palms up. Good, take an inhale. And exhale. I like to place one hand on my heart so I can really focus on grounding here and breath. Find a little gratitude for yourself for making it to your mat today, for carving out time for your self-care. This is an investment not just in the time you spent here, but in your long-term health bank. So thank you for being here. Thank yourselves for being here. Thank you, Sarah, for being my demo. I wish you all a fantastic rest of your day.